Hello, and welcome to another edition of Creative Artists Cultural Exchange, International Television. I'm Fikisha Kombo, executive producer and host of this cultural travelogue to the Kingdom of Morocco.
Morocco, a country where man and nature work as one, where clay is transformed by the architect, are molded at the potter's wheel. Bright metals are transformed into jewelry and ornaments. Wool is woven into stunning patterns and traditional designs. Wood is carved with skill and inlaid with delicate marquetry. Morocco has a profusion of treasures behind the walls of its towns and cities. CACE INT'L traveled to the Kingdom of Morocco 3 times. The first time, we were invited by our African-American cultural ambassador to Morocco, renowned pianist and composer Randy Weston, who was given complete travel packages by the King, King Hassan II of Morocco, to invite creative artists from the United States. The occasion was the 10-day International Festival of Music and Youth, which was based in Marrakesh and was followed by a James Brown concert in Casablanca. James Brown's concert was produced by Mr. Weston's friend, whom he introduced us to, artist, entrepreneur, Zine Abdellatif, the president of the Moroccan Artists and Printers Association. Musicians, artists, writers, and television from all over the world attended the Festival of Music and Youth in Marrakesh. Marrakesh has much of the cheerfulness associated with Black Africa. In its history, Marrakesh looked always to the south, in apprehension of another sort by turbulent tribes of the desert contesting its power, or eagerly as the source of trade from the great caravans which periodically left its gates. Old men there can still remember the days when 1,000 camels would gather on the square of the Jemaa el-Fna for the journey across the Sahara. At the performance part of the festival, held at the foot of the Katubia, colorful Moroccan carpets covered the grounds. In the huge Arabian tents, low multi-designed pillows set flush on the carpets, and musicians, writers, and artists lounged, drinking the national beverage, mint tea. Framed by the snowy heights of the Atlas, with rose-colored ramparts and a 1,000-year-old palm grove, Marrakesh casts a magic spell, sumptuous and exuberant. It radiates splendor and mysticism, especially at festival time, in the rhythm of the music, in the motion of the dancers. The highlight of the festival was a gathering at a gigantic restaurant, often called the Fantasia, where Berbers and Ganawans sing and dance and serve hot couscous and other authentic Moroccan cuisine. The Fantasia performed. Actually, the Fantasia is an extraordinary war exercise in which men on horseback perform the most extraordinary acrobatic feats and fire their mukhala, which are old powder charged rifles, during a frantic gallop, all in perfect synchronization. Traditions and folk art remain very much alive in Morocco. Music is present everywhere in the country, accompanying festivities and ceremonies. In the towns, it has developed into an instrumental form. This is traditional, classical, or popular Arab music. In rural or Berber tribes, music is intimately linked with poetry and dance. The folk dances are magnificent and accompany the tribe's everyday life. The Berbers have always lived a village life, governed in a democratic manner by representative councils with a member from each family group. Very few Berber men take more than one wife. Today, only about half the population of Morocco speak Berber at home and consider themselves Berber. But nevertheless, the vast majority of the Moroccans must in fact be descended from Berber stock. Of the most important regional saints, an annual festival is held. These festivals are known as musims and combine devotion, commerce, and entertainment. On the open ground beside the shrine, a great number of tents are erected. Around the outside are the black tents of the semi-nomads, who will camp there. Then there are simple white tents or shelters, which serve as booths for the display of goods to be sold. And these are often set up in rows, like the streets of a village. Towering here and there, above the others, are the tall, circular, white caïdal tents, with their rows of black chessboard figure patterns and pointed roofs. They will house the notables or provide a place for eating and drinking. In the evening, there will be music and dancing groups. The highlight of the Moussin is always the Fantasia, held in the late afternoon as the heat of the day wanes. Teams of horsemen, magnificently mounted, gather at one end of a long open space. At a sign, the horses of the first team stop prancing on the spot to dash forward in a fast gallop, their riders throwing up their long rifles in the air. As they reach the end of the ride, all must fire their rifles at the same moment in the air and rein in their mounts to a crashing halt. It is the precision with which they carry out these two maneuvers that determines the winning team. From the Straits of Gibraltar to Mauritania. The Atlantic Ocean is to its west, the Mediterranean to the north. Wonderful beaches, four mountain ranges with cascading waterfalls, century-old cedar forest, eternal snows, immense plains flowering with orange and almond blossoms, rivers that lay out a carpet of greenery to the threshold of the desert and carve out spectacular gorges. Morocco has been inhabited since very early prehistoric times, as the many prehistoric remains show. Then came the Phoenicians, Carthaginians, Berbers, Byzantines, Romans, and Vandals before the Arab invasion. Today, Morocco is a constitutional monarchy. King Hussein II came to the throne in 1961. He is also Morocco's religious leader. The population is 26 million, of which 50% are under 20 years old and 70% under 30. Annual sunshine levels are more than 8 hours a day.